All right, continuing on with this information overload here. This is a little stage called Avoid Poor Time. Box. Too much time may not be frustrating, but it can be seen... Yeah, that's right. The time is actually quite a vital part of the stage to kind of to get you to get to the end quickly, but not so tightly that it'll make frustration too. Like this right here. Next one. Yeah, all these on these first three rows from top to bottom are information boxes. Have someone who's good at breaking levels test a hack to make sure there's nothing too easy to skip or otherwise break. Yeah, that's also a pretty good idea there, because don't give feathers in levels that you can fly right over them and stuff like that. Avoid having all the yes, that's another thing that people can get stuck in is just jumping over a wall, and then they end up inside this trap that they can't get out of, and why can't I bounce on these note blocks? Please avoid unique... Oh, yes, definitely. If there's something tedious, you definitely don't want to be listening to the same song repeat, 5-second loops all the time. Yeah, that too. That's kind of like what I was saying in that other cave level. Avoid remakes... Especially they're referring to level 1-1s. Yep. I've seen a lot of 1-1 remakes, and they aren't really creative, just as that said, because somebody already created them. The actual creator of the game already, you know, it's make your own sort of dealio. That's the point of making a hack, after all, right? I suppose that's a pretty good idea, unless you want to, enhance the level concepts and stuff like that. That last tip, use map 16 to be clever is nice, but using my... I don't know what map 16 is, I'm sorry. Death rooms... I'd have to disagree with this one a little bit. They are kind of funny a little bit. Because you can just rewind out of them using an emulator, so... they are kind of funny in a way when there's something unfair like that, but not constantly. But at least that's in my opinion. Please, please do not make narrow mazes, no block mazes, and check mazes, and anything of the... Yeah, that's true. You want to keep up the variety and keep things interesting. At least that's my opinion too. If a maze or a puzzle is... then make sure there's enough time in the clock to complete the puzzle, or... Yeah, definitely. A lot of times they make a puzzle level with 100 seconds, and they expect you to know what you have to do, or figure out what you have to do really quickly, and it's I can't do it in time. That you can't do it in time. I'm going behind this wall here. Can I go? Yeah, I can go in front of these darker things. That's very nice. I'm just saying very nice and awesome a lot. Way to go for very unique commentary. I do not. Oh, that must mean, what I'm doing right now here, to go behind objects. I would guess that if you accidentally make some blocks not go on the right layer, it's gonna look really weird, you know, because Mario will go right in front of him, it'll look like he's going right through a wall. And it looks like we're going to a dangerous castle. Ooh, darkness. It's spooky, and I'll just grab that to save my feather and get myself a pop. Go, and what's wrong with me with going in pipes today? Boink, boink, and oh, why did I grab that? I wanted to keep my feather. Sometimes it adds a nice effect if the level is dark with a switch, but don't use it all the time. And yes, if a level is constantly dark, it's just not fun to play, because you're just, it's very, very hard to see, and it really isn't fair. As it's boxing, the light mess up when hit, they turn light black until the message goes away. Yeah, that's evidently another glitch. I never encountered that glitch in a hack or anything like that, so I can't say, but evidently that's something that you should be looking forward to, looking for when you make a dark area. It will? I didn't know that. I don't know that either. this episode really is information overload here. correct sprites to bunk. And unlike transparency blocks, the on-off blocks will mess up graphically of a level. I don't know that either! I gotta mess around with Lunar Magic Lock. Will this switch? Yes, it will change the palette of the thingy up here again. Boink. Boink. See, like that? Okay. There are many ASM blocks and sprites you can make. I don't know what that is as well. As I said, I've only tinkered with the bare basics of Lunar Magic. Next one. Another castle thing. Oh, it's actually bonus town! It's very neon green. Learn how to use the SNES registers and level modes. Try to... I don't know what that means either! Dang it! I feel like such a Lunar Magic noob. Like that one I didn't know either. Arg! I only know about the gameplay. Woo, transparent. That's it. One more, and then I'm gonna split this part in half. Sprite buoyancy, I'm pretty sure they're talking about, yeah, these things here. And potables, I bet you they're also talking about. Yes, like, these are definitely sprite buoyancy things here. Yep, there's the potables, or potoboos, whatever you wanna call them, and yeah. And now, hold on. Alright, continuing on here, we're gonna start with the left side all the way to the right side until I get to that star there. This one is called Ice Paradise. And we've got the awesome Sonic music going on here. I believe this is the... I just remember the music. It's from the multiplayer Mystic Cave Zone, I believe it's called. And the... Oh, why did I jump? Or right... Or, I mean, why did I slide? Oh, it's icy. Why was I thinking that they're regular physics? I am an idiot. It said Ice Cave. And I don't know if I could drop down. Okay, I can drop down tonight. And just look... Oh, this... Again, this looks really nice. There's overlapping colors to create different color effects. Say they're Charlie, I'd like to bounce on your head. And I did. And I'm speechless, and that's pretty hard to do with me. And can I go down here? Can I go down? Yes, I can. Why? What's with my problem with going in pipes? Jesus. Message box will not work with level modes 1E or 1F as the color becomes transparent. Ah, so I guess they don't work with transparency? I don't know. Yes, that is also very true, and I can't go through there. A whole load of icy levels in a hack is just not... it's not very interesting when it's always icy, and they are also very annoying. It's ice and stages were designed to annoy you. Keep that in mind, people. It's designed to make it harder, but at the same time, make it so you slide into stuff and obstacles and stuff like that. Abusing the ice is not a good idea. And yes, I knew that thing ended the level. It's just like Super Mario Brothers 3. Yeah, it's number 3s where those little question mark thingies are. Next one! More than one way. I think I only have time for this level, and then that's it for this part. And there's a secret exit. If I'm not mistaken. Out of my way! Yeah! Keep in mind there are two directions. Yes, that is true as well. If a level always goes to the left, it wouldn't be very interesting. I mean, if a level only goes to the right, like all the levels only go to the right, that would get kind of redundant after all. You know, like repetitive, I should say, not redundant. And I gotta find the keyhole really quick, don't I? There it is. Now, oh, what the heck? Oh, there we go. Because I've seen a lot of them that just go only to the right, or, you know, it's just, would be nice to see them go vertical, to the left, downward, stuff like that. It's just to keep up the variety and to increase your level design possibilities. As I said, I'm not a designer expert, but I just notice this kind of stuff when I'm playing hacks. And on the pipe, and that this actually seemed like a pretty bland area, to be honest. I guess that's the point, is to show off absolute vanilla graphics altogether. It's not possible. Yes, like having Tails 115's crazy awesome formations like this, crazy abstract formations like this. I just love levels that look like this, abstract levels, and boop, they're right in the water, and right out of the water, and there's another dragon coin. I knew that was there, I seen it as I was going up, so I decided to jump on it, and I actually ran into the Koopa before the fireball did. Nice! Vanilla levels are quite a bit more difficult to make look good. With enough creativity and attention, they can look great. Yes, like this one. Just look at those nice diagonal things attached to all the platforms, so it looks like they're floating in midair, and that's the end of the level. So I guess that's the end of this part, so I guess I'll see you guys later in the next part.